Parliament is set to debate the Public Accounts Committee report tomorrow on the 142 billion shillings government paid out to businessman Hassan Basajjabalaba.
And this report, as I said, was tabled last week. So it's hopeful that tomorrow, as I've been advised, that it will be debated by the entire House. All of them signed. It is the only report so far in the history of this parliament.
The 65-page report implicates Minister Syda Bbumba and Professor Kiddu Makubuya for causing financial loss to the taxpayers amounting to 88 billion Uganda shillings paid out in excess.
From 54 billion shillings to 88, from 88 to 96, from 96 to 142.6 billion shillings, single-handedly, and he could not give any plausible explanation.
The report recommends that the two ministers must take political and personal responsibility for causing financial loss to government and be relieved of their duties.
Honorable Syda Bbumba, who acted as if, you know, she was giving money from her personal account, giving directives to the governor, telling the governor, you see, this is this, we must do this.
The report also implicates the Governor Bank of Uganda, Emmanuel Tumusiime Mutebile, and that he should also be relieved of his duties. Professor Kiddu Makubuya, in a letter to the committee chairman Kassiano Wadri, is asking to be availed with recorded evidence to guide him in his defense.
Professor Kiddu Makubuya is entitled. It is very clearly stated in our rules of procedure, and he has written to me and copied it to the speaker, among other people.
Some lawmakers have been up in arms, calling for the resignation of the two ministers, or else they face censure.
Now time is ripe for them to move the censure motion. They can now move it. It's now time.
If the report is adopted by the whole House, the Inspector General of Government, the IGG, and the Criminal Investigative Department of Police, the CID, will take on Makubuya, Bbumba and Mutebile, with a view to prosecute them if they find them culpable. Jingo Francis, NTV Parliament.